Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the CanXida range of supplements. Thanks for checking out my video today. We're doing another one in the Citrobacter Freundii series. So you may have just previously watched a video called What is Citrobacter? So if you haven't, check it out. We're going to talk about how you know if you've got a Citrobacter infection. Well, this particular bacterial infection can be quite hard to pick unless you're doing a specialized stool test, but I generally find that some of the stool symptoms include pain. So a bit of a pain around the gut region or the lower gut region is quite common. Bloating, gas, diarrhea. A stool test will often show this, especially a comprehensive stool test, and we'll also very commonly find high levels of inflammation. So Citrobacter occurs in many people commonly, but kept right in balance and in check by many other kinds of bacteria. But it can actually become a really big problem, especially in immunocompromised people. So if you've got serious stress for years, you've got poor adrenal function, you've got fatigue, you know, you've got low blood pressure and you're cold and you've got a lot of the symptoms associated with adrenal fatigue, that's when these kind of bacteria can cause a lot of symptoms and problems in your body because they get the upper hand. They get in there and they create problems. They create inflammation. They jam up your immune system. Bloody diarrhea, mucus in the stools. These are the sort of symptoms that can sometimes drive you to the doctor who will refer you to the gastroenterologist who will do a colonoscopy or an endoscopy and find nothing. In those cases, do a comprehensive digestive stool analysis. Three samples, including parasitology. Very important to do for diagnosis. But the symptoms, as I mentioned, often will be GI-related symptoms. Pain, bloating, gas, diarrhea, more commonly than constipation. Some people can pass out in the stools. So those are the common ones. As I mentioned in the previous video, it can be linked to meningitis kind of symptoms and like severe urinary tract infections. It can also be cultured in the urine with very bad urinary tract kind of infections. It can sometimes affect the respiratory of the people, respiratory tract, but more commonly found in the gut. Citrobacter is found all over the place. It can be on surfaces anywhere. So make sure, it's all about cleanliness and hygiene. It's the best way to avoid any kind of bacterial overgrowth. But even more importantly, it's more important for you to have a good immune function to counter these kind of imbalances. Thanks for checking out my video.